powerless. I'm not helpless. I don't believe addiction is a disease, and frankly, I'm scared and angered by the suggestion that from now on, it's either eternal abstinence or binge to death. I can't surrender myself to a higher power because there isn't one. There just isn't, and you, as someone who lives in the 21st century, should know that. I mean, I wake up in wet sheets. In places I don't recognize, with bruises I can't account for, men I don't know. I've stolen from people, I've slept on the streets, I'm in trouble. I know that. But this, this book, this process can't help me. You can't help me. You want me to conceptualize a universe in which I am the sole agent of my destiny and at the same time acknowledge my absolute powerlessness. I am not the product of the decisions I've made or the things that have happened to me. I won't be reduced to that.
Look out, look out, look out. Everybody's ready up at letter A, top of page 5. Ready?
Thank you. excuse me? Excuse me! Hi. Thank you so much for stopping. I'm so sorry to bother you. I love your help. I never do this. I'm sorry. It's just kind of an emergency. Oh, no, don't worry. It's like not the end of the world or anything. It's just, oh, this is so embarrassing. Oh, okay, so thank you so much for stopping. Here's the thing. As I was driving, I'm going to my mother's house. Yeah, the Prius? Yeah, that's me. So anyway, as I was driving, I just accidentally killed my husband. I know, it's so embarrassing. Oh my gosh. I'm so sorry, I forgot to introduce myself. I'm Ashley. What's your name? Susan? That's my mom's name. Yeah, I'm not kidding. So anyway, I just killed my husband and I was wondering if, I'm sorry? Oh, that's a good question. I probably should have started there. So we were joking around and he was joshing me about how bad of a driver I am and I got kind of peeved because, well, I don't know why. Usually I'm very even-tempered, but things have been kind of tough lately. So anyway, I got peeved and I said, well, if you hate the way I drive so much, why don't you get out of the car? And he said, okay, I will. And so I pull over and he steps out. And then as a joke, I pretended to hit him with my car. But here's the thing, I actually am a pretty bad driver. And here's the thing, I did hit him. Yeah, and I thought, well, hey, people get hit by cars all the time. I'm sure I didn't do any serious damage, but here's the thing, I did. Yeah, it's the kind of thing that can happen to anyone, but when it happens to you, you're like, ah! What do I do, you know? So what I was wondering is, do you mind if I just load him into your back seat and we drive him over to the hospital real quick? It'd be real quick. I have somewhere I have to be myself in about half an hour. I'm sorry. Well, I can't very well put him in my back seat. I got both the kids back there.
I am a poet. I am very fond of bananas. I am bananas. I am very fond of a poet. I am a poet. I am bananas. I am a poet. I am bananas. I am a poet.
I am a poet. I am very fond of bananas. I am bananas. I am very fond of a poet.
I am a poet.
I am very fond of a poet.
I am a poet.
I am bananas. I am a poet. I am very fond of a fond poet. I am.
Very bananas.
Fond of.
Am I bananas?
Am I?
A very poet.
Bananas of a poet.
Very fond bananas. Am I a poet?
See, now I'll tell you something about me. I done strung along going this way and that, whichever way would lead me to a moment of peace. That's all I want in life is to be easy with everything. But I wasn't born to that. I was born to a time of fire. The world ain't wanted no part of me. And I noticed that since I was about 7 years old. The world says it's better off without me. See, Bernice accepts that. She's trying to play up to where she can prove something to the world. But I don't see it like Bernice. I got a heart that beats here. When it beats just as loud as the next fellow's. I don't care if you're black or white, sometimes it beats even louder. When it beats louder, then everybody can hear it. See, some people get scared of that, like Bernice. They think you ought to lay low with that heartbeat. They think you ought to let it beat so quiet and just go along with it the way things are. But mama ain't birthed me for nothing. I got to mark my passion on the road just like you will mark your name on that tree. Boy, Willie was here. And that's all I'm trying to do with selling that piano.